Hello, my name is MM John Odo. I am a bead designer by profession and also an educationist. I was trained at the College of Education of Afaransich, and I came back to be trained as a bead maker. So I'm here to drill you and teach you on how to make a bead bow tie. We have different types of beads, but for today's drilling, we are going to consider the ball beads, the rice beads. Then we have the scissors for the cutting of the fishing line. And also we have the tape for the measurement of the fishing line. We have the needle for the needling work of the bead. We have the elastic to go back around the bow tie. First, you cut the fishing line to the measurement you want. You cut it. Use the scissors in cutting it. Then you add your rice bead. It forms a layer of your work. Then you add the ball bead to it. You add the ball, you add the rice bead. Then you continue with the ball. You use the other hand, add the ball. You turn to this other side, you add the ball. Then we have three here. Then you use the rice bead to intercross your wick. Just like this. And this is the shape you have at the first step of it. Then you continue doing it like that. You put the ball. You put the ball at the left hand side. Then you use the rice to intercross it. Now have this shape. That's how you move it. You continue putting the ball to your right and the left, then you intercross with the right bead. So you get the length want for your bow tie. When it's long, and when you have the desired size and the shape, you can turn it. Then you add the other layer. About to get to the next line of the beading work. You turn your rope to the other side. You have the desired shape of add your rice again. Then you add your ball. And also you go back to your rice. Then you intercross it again. You have the second line of the wick. This is the second line. Continue matting it. You use this rope as a connecting rope. You pass it. While this other rope, you use it for the dropping of the bead.
intercross with the rice to give you the desired shape. Connect the rope to the previous line. Then you use this other side to pass the bead down. You now intercross with the rice bead. This type of beading is called matting beading. From the matting beading, you continue passing the rope. You use this other side as a dropping line. Continue your work. You can see it's very interesting doing it. You get down to the last line of the turning point. Place your rice bead again. Then you intercross with the ball so that it can connect with the other line we are going into. Then you get to the other line of the wake. How it looks like. We've gotten up to the third line. Now turn it. You continue passing the rope and adding your beads in line. Get the desired shape. Should I put that? The second line of the beading. This is the rope, and this is the mouth. This is the ball bead. You pass it gently to the hold of the bead. You draw it hard. Then the next line, you add the rice bead, and you also add the ball bead to it. As the third line of the bridge. Continue doing it like that, like this, putting the rope inside the ball and adding the
and also adding the ball bead. You now intercross it with the rice bead. Shape and the length of your bow tie.
Okay.
When you have the desired shape of your bead, you now put a straight rope so that you can bend the mouth of your work. In bending the mouth of your work, you bend your bead, you put the long fishing line, you bevel the bead, and you use one other bead to cross it. Bend the mouth of the bow tie. You pass it to the rice bead to get the shape. In bending the mouth of your wick, bending the work, you use the ball bead to intercross it. Now this is your rope, now this is your ball. You draw it harder to make your work strong and neat. You pass it again with the rice in between the lines of your work. Then you add another ball to tighten the bending. You put it back. Hold it strong. You add the ball to it. The last stage of it, you add the last ball.
Boss.
Now you add the last ball to it to close the mouth of your bow tie. You add the one, the bean's bead. Nobody needs to see the rope, so you hide your rope inside the beading, the beaded wick. Till the gobi, the rope is gone. You use your scissors to trim the end of the rope. Then you bend the other mouth of it. You cut your fishing line again. You add your fishing line to the three balls by the end of the beaded work. When you bend the weight, you add one ball to reach. Pass the rope to the rise beach again. Also pass to the down rise beach. Then you use the ball to close the space. You intercross it again. You intercross the wake. You drag it hard to make your work stronger. Then you continue passing it. Then you intercross again with the ball. Then you pass again to the right. You pass the down rope to the other down right beach. Then you use the ball also again to intercross your way. Shape of your boat.
Okay.
After getting the desired size and shape of the bow tie, you now bevel the middle mouth. You hold it with your fingers. The shape of the bow tie. For it to be strong and fine, you use the fishing line again to knit the back of it. Now you use one ball bead. Put the ball bit inside the rope. Then you take the ball bit to the middle. You count your wake. You get down to the middle of your wake. You pass the rope, the left hand side, and also you pass to the right hand side of your wake. now this is what you have at the back. You use a ball bit again to mat it. You add the ball bit. This is the shape of your bow tie. The bending of the bow tie. You pass it again. You pass it to the right ball side of your wake. Drag the rope to make your wake to be stronger and neat. You get the ball bit for the last pass. That's the last. You get the desired size and the length of the bow tie. This is how your bow tie looks like. Okay. The next one. So as you want to be neat, you put back your ropes. That you've gotten the shape, you can use scissors to trim the ropes, the fishing line. It's okay. You now pick your elastic. You measure the length of the head of the bow tie. You use a scissors. You cut it with a scissors. You now, this is the back of your bow tie. You pass your elastic under what you're using. Your needle. She put the rope. Now you use the needle and the thread already put in. You use it. You sew the back mouth of the elastic. Till it knits and stronger. After sewing the elastic, this is what you get. That's the head of the person, and this is the front, is the bow tie. This is my bow tie, ready for occasion. Thanks for watching, and we hope to meet again next time on our next bead making.